your argument. So does it apply only to criminal punishment? What about the privatization of other coercive powers, such as regulatory punishment?
Which are
opposed to criminal punishment, you know, the private activity is valued by the community, it's welcomed and not condemned. So just as an example, what about privatizing the state power to impose fines or other administrative punishments or to set rules in order to regulate the industry? There is no real substantial wrongdoing there, but more damage control. So I was wondering about that. And second, you talked about the difference between contract and status. And this is a question I struggle with as well. And I was wondering, what about the cases where the government doesn't contract out by tenders and contract, but authorized private agents? Just as an example, in Israel, the Attorney General fined every year on personal authorizations to private lawyers to file lawsuits in the name of the state. So how do you address these cases?
So the situation